So what do I do to find a guy? I felt like you asked. Well, I don't do dating apps. That never works for me. I go dancing. You know, house music. That's what I listen to. Yeah. I love it. Once a week. I go every week. It's great exercise. I go, I meet someone. That's a great way to meet someone. And it's like right in front of you. You got your rhythm. He's got his. It's great. But my girlfriend, who I go with, now this is in New York now, you know, because I'm there. So I go once a week there and I go. My girlfriend, she hates men. Because, you know, the Me Too movement. It's got women on high alert. I get it. You know, she's like angry. She's putting men on lists. If I say anything about her, he's on a list. I go, what list? He's on a list. She's angry. And that's fine, I guess. But she brings that energy to the dance club. The place where I am the most hopeful. And she gets angry at men. Like, she's a great dancer, too. She'll be dancing, and they'll come up to her, and she's like, get the fuck away from me. And they're like, what did I do? I don't understand what happened. She gets mad when they touch me. She's like, you don't want that. I go, no, I want this. No, I need this. She's just slapping dick away. Just get out of here. Just swiping left for me. Guy was dancing with me. She was like, that's an assault. I go, no, this is mating. Look, this is my peacock right here. This is my peacock. I mess with my peacock. But I do understand her on some level because some men don't know how to dance with you. They're space-wise. I hate when guys, like, face dance you. You know, when they... You're like, back up, motherfucker, back up. I see you. I think I'm a great dancer, by the way. I think I'm fine. But I have a lot of comedian friends who make fun of me. They like to ruin it. I have a friend, Keith Robinson. He always likes to, he's like, you've been doing the same move for 20 years. I was like, this is my move. He's like, same move, 20 years. And he gets in my head, and I'm like, you know, you're supposed to dance like nobody's watching. I was on the dance floor. I had this motherfucker in my head. So I'm trying to do my move. I'm like, oh, maybe that's not the move. But I do love going to this club. I go every week. They know me there now to the point where I think they don't like me. The woman at the door, this is when I go to pay. She's like, go, just please keep your coupon. I don't even want it. Co-check girls, they know me. They know all my dating stories. I tell them, even if they don't want to hear it, they're like, okay. Ida in the bathroom. I love the bathroom attendant. I love Ida. I work for her sometimes, you know. She has to go to the bathroom, so I fill in. My friends, I'll come out. They'll be like, where were you? I was like, I had to work. To help out. But one time I got into a fight. Kind of, not really. It was someone's birthday that worked at the club, and a woman was serving cake for the birthday. And she normally is the t-shirt lady for the DJ. She sells t-shirts for the DJ. But today she was serving cake, and I guess she didn't want to. But I didn't know that. I just walk up, I see my friend Lori there, and I'm like, hey Lori, where you been? She's helping her, you know, cut cake and stuff. So the woman comes at me. She's like, you want cake? Bitch, it ain't your birthday. What the hell are you so aggressive for? With the, you know, but you know how you do with cake. You just go, no cake. No cake. Intermittent fasting, you know. No cake after 8. Do you want cake? I was like, no. Why is she so upset? She said again, do you want cake? I was like, no. She's like, then goodbye, goodbye. And I was like. Speaking of strong black woman, it's not my reaction. I was like. mean, and you know, here's the thing, like, I look at this, I work out, I can, you know, I box 4 times a week, but wait. I forgot to mention, this was a Latino woman in a bad mood with a knife. Cutting cake. Sometimes, you know, part of my training is you gotta do the math. Like, I trained to box, and but she looked like she never had to train. Looked like it was just in her. And I walked away. I was so uncomfortable. You know, you ever look at your phone because you're so uncomfortable, you look for a text? There's nothing there. So I text my friend Lori. I go, why didn't you say anything? You know, you always get mad at men touching me. Why didn't you say anything to Cake Bitch? I was so upset, man.